Right now, of those MLAs who have quit, it is now official. It is now official. Abhishek, those pictures that we are talking about, that the information coming through sources that they have submitted to the Raj Bhavan, their resignation, they have now put up these pictures with their resignation letters in their hands.
Well, that's a confirmation. That's a confirmation, Amitha, that the resignations have been sent.
Yes.
And these MLAs, I can count 17 of them, if I missed the frame. No, actually 18 of them. And these MLAs have sent their resignations. Right, 19 MLAs, and they have sent their resignation to the Speaker of the Madhya Pradesh Assembly. And which means that Kamal Nath government is already a minority government, Amita, because I believe they had 119 in the House, and if the 19 are struck off, it leaves them with 100, and that's 15 short of the halfway mark or the simple majority that is needed in the Madhya Pradesh Assembly of 228 legislatures. So, legislators. So clearly, it's a case of a change of government impending in Madhya Pradesh on the back of Jyotiraditya Scindia developments, beginning with sidelining of the senior leader from within the Madhya Pradesh unit of the party, and then the government that was formed in December 2018. Step by step, the manner in which he was sidelined, his men were sidelined, his supporters were sidelined. He requesting the top leadership of the Congress party to intervene, not getting his concerns redressed, concerns becoming grievances, grievances becoming grudges, and grudges leading to this step where Jyotiraditya Scindia is ultimately out of the Congress party and into the BJP fold. It's a lesson in how not to handle how not to allow a small issue become a crisis for the Congress leadership if any of them are really bothered to take lessons and prevent the downslide of the Congress party in Indian polity. We have seen how it is not just about Jyotiraditya Scindia. Off and on, we have been hearing it in the case of Sachin Pilot. We saw how it happened in the case of Haryana. And we are hearing it in case of other leaders also. And in fact, I can tell you, Amita, and for the viewers, that Jyotiraditya Scindia is leaving is just a beginning. It's a message to the Young Turks that they can explore greener pastures outside of the Congress party and succeed. So depending on what they bring on the table, they can really make their careers outside of the moribund and unresponsive structures of the Congress leadership. And that is exactly what we are seeing panning out.
So let's talk about the numbers now. Let's talk about the numbers now, Abhishek. 114 was with the Indian National Congress. Minus 19, 95. That brings the Bharatiya Janata Party to 107 where they stand as of now. The numbers are important.
It never looked good, really, for the MP Congress, Amita, to begin with. In fact, if you recall, and the viewers would know, that even if the Congress party really came to power in Madhya Pradesh, what is important is the vote share of the BJP was 1% more than the Congress party. So it's not that the BJP really lost in terms of its appeal with the masses in Madhya Pradesh. It's just that the numbers really did not add up given the way electoral politics really plays out. So the BJP would perhaps use that as a moral high ground when it comes to numbers. Let's go to Satyavijay, who's there in Bhopal, keeping track of all developments of the crisis for the Kamal Nath government. Satyavijay, what is your sense? What are you getting to understand it? Numbers really pan out for both BJP and the Congress party in the assembly after these resignations of 19 MLAs.
जी हाँ, देखिए कांग्रेस के जो 19 विधायक थे, जिसमें मंत्री हैं तुलसी सिलावट, प्रद्युम्न सिंह तोमर, ये वो मंत्री जो सिंधिया खेमे के थे, महेंद्र सिंह सिसोदिया, इसके अलावा गोविंद सिंह राजपूत, जो तस्वीर आ रही है, जो 19 विधायकों ने इस्तीफा दिया है, हाथों में उनके इस्तीफे का लेटर भी है, तो इन सभी विधायकों ने इस्तीफा दे दिया. तो ऐसे में भाजपा के देखिए 107 MLA अभी थे और कांग्रेस के 114 MLA थे. अब 114 में से 114 में से 19 विधायक माइनस कर दिए जाएंगे, तो जाहिर सी बात है जो आंकड़ा है। सर 19 विधायकों की इस्तीफे की तस्वीर आ गई है।
तो ऐसी स्थिति में स्वाभाविक है कि वर्तमान सरकार ने बहुमत अगर खोने की स्थिति आती है तो माननीय राज्यपाल उनको निर्देश देते हैं, हम मानते हैं संवैधानिक प्रक्रिया अपनी पद्धति से आगे बढ़ेगी। माननीय राज्यपाल महोदय इसकी चिंता करने के लिए सक्षम है, हमारा यहाँ आना महज राज्यसभा के चुनाव में हमारी रणनीति को सफलता की ओर ले जाना इतना ही।
ये थे बिने सबुद्धे जिन्होंने बताया कि देखिए स्वाभाविक प्रक्रिया थी, चूंकि कांग्रेस के विधायक संतुष्ट नहीं थे इसीलिए उन्होंने इस्तीफा दिया। बिने सबुद्धे सुबह आठ बजे से भाजपा दफ्तर में थे, उन्होंने बीडी शर्मा जो कि प्रदेश अध्यक्ष हैं, शिवराज सिंह चौहान और तमाम जो नेता हैं, गोपाल भार्गव, इन सभी से मुलाकात की थी और फिलहाल रिपब्लिक से उन्होंने बातचीत की बिने सबुद्धे ने, जिन्होंने कहा कि उनका इस घटनाक्रम से कोई लेना देना नहीं है, वो सिर्फ राज्यसभा में कौन प्रत्याशी होगा इसके लिए आए थे। लेकिन जैसा कि मैं बता रहा था, अगर आंकड़ों की बात की जाए तो 114 जो विधायक हैं कांग्रेस का जो नंबर है वो 114 का था, इसमें से 19 लोगों के इस्तीफे की तस्वीर सामने आ चुकी है। मतलब जाहिर तौर पर अभी जो विधानसभा का नंबर है वो 228 है, क्योंकि दो सीटों पर बाई इलेक्शन होना है, तो 228 में से 115 वो मैजिक फिगर है जिसमें की सरकार बनती है। ऐसे में साफ है कि 19 विधायक अगर कांग्रेस से माइनस कर दें तो अब उनके पास कुछ भी नहीं बचा है।